Let's start with lesson 1. Akbar and Birbal. Once Emperor Akbar fell ill, the doctor was readily called in. Since the doctor did not like Birbal, one of Akbar's 9 gems, he planned to teach Birbal a lesson and thought for king's remedy accordingly. Soon, the doctor felt the pulse of the emperor in order to diagnose him. He said to Akbar, "Your Majesty, I have a medicine that will heat you up again, but you must take it with bull's milk." Akbar was taken aback and asked, "Where will I get bull's milk?" "Please ask Birbal to arrange it for you," said the cunning doctor. Birbal was puzzled when he came to know about it. But somehow he overcame that state of mind and realized that it was the trick of the doctor to leave him in the lurch. Birbal came back home grim and gloomy. Being asked by his daughter, he described her the whole matter. No sooner had she listened to her father than she got ready to carry out this responsibility. At midnight, when all the people of the town were fast asleep, Birbal's daughter took a pile of clothes and reached the river just below Akbar's bedroom's window. She began to wash them, making peculiar sound, thwack, splash. Thwack! Akbar couldn't help scolding his guard and sent him to find out the person making so much noise in the night. The guard reached the spot. However, to his surprise, he saw that a lady was washing her clothes. The guard asked her sternly, "Who are you?" The lady replied, "I am my father's daughter." The guard asked impatiently, "Who is your father?" She said, "He is my mother's husband." Being impatient and irritated, the guard thought he would hardly collect any information from her this way. So, he told her to appear before the emperor. When the girl appeared before the emperor, Akbar asked her, "Why were you washing clothes in the middle of the night?" "Your Majesty, I beg your pardon because I could not help it. I needed clean clothes for my father who had given birth to a baby," she said. Akbar was in utter astonishment. The girl replied, "Your Majesty, nothing is impossible these days. If a bull can give milk, why can't a man give birth to a baby?" As soon as Akbar heard this explanation, he instantly guessed who she was. Such a clever and witty girl could only be Birbal's daughter. He laughed and said, "You won. Now you go home and inform your father that I accept my defeat." She bowed her head to Emperor and happily left for home.